In this video, we're going to show you how to make payments on the Maine Tax Portal. Before we begin, these videos use example numbers for the purpose of demonstrating how the Maine Tax Portal, also known as the portal, works as a system and the basic mechanics of how to use the portal. The videos do not constitute tax advice. If you have a question about how to file your own taxes, how to file taxes for your business, or how to file the taxes you are preparing on behalf of an individual or entity, you should seek assistance from a tax professional. Now back to the content of this video. We'll be showing you two types of non-logged-in payments and a logged-in payment. We'll start off with the non-logged-in payments, so we'll begin on the Maine Tax Portal homepage. Here, various options are organized into categories using separate panels. We're looking for the Make a Payment hyperlink, which can be found in both the Quick Links panel and the Individuals panel. You may click either. Both will bring you to the same page. From here, we have three options. We can make an estimated or extension payment. We can make a bill payment. Or we can make a real estate withholding payment. Real estate withholding, or REW payments, are not covered in this video. If you are attempting to remit a payment that would otherwise be paid using a Maine form REW-1, please see that video instead. We'll begin with the estimated or extension payment. So we'll click that hyperlink, and we'll enter in the type of payment that we're trying to make, estimated or extension. For the purposes of this demonstration, we're going to make an estimated payment. We'll select the account type for which we are making this payment. And enter the year for which we are making this payment. Next, we'll enter in our ID number. And again to confirm. Keeping in mind as we navigate through these pages, required fields are indicated by a red asterisk. And we'd also like to draw your attention to the Save Draft button at the bottom of the screen. You may use this at any time to save your progress, or you may click Cancel anytime to end the activity and not save your progress. You can navigate back to a previous page by clicking either the Previous button or by clicking a previous page name in the blue bar at the top. So we'll continue on throughout this process, entering in the required information, including our phone number and first and last name. For this demonstration, we are making an individual income tax payment. So there are fields for the spouse's first and last name and the spouse's ID number as well. Since that's not applicable for this demonstration, we're just going to move on. Next, we are asked to provide our address. As always, addresses must be verified by the United States Postal Service, which you can do by clicking the blue hyperlink at the bottom of the screen. And once we verify the address, we'll click Next to proceed. Next, we'll enter in our payment method, including our routing number, account number, and account number again to confirm. We will also indicate whether this account is checking or savings. And we can edit our payment date and amount as needed. The payment date will default to today, but you may future date if you so choose. We'll enter in the amount of the payment, and then again to confirm. And we'll click Next to continue. On the summary screen, the information provided throughout this activity is reiterated back to us. We'll confirm that everything looks correct and click Submit. We are asked to enter in our email address, twice to confirm. This will allow you to search the submission later. And we'll click OK. The email address we provided is reiterated back to us on the confirmation screen, along with our confirmation code. As always, we encourage you to make note of that information for your records. Since we're going to also demonstrate a bill payment, we're going to navigate back to the payment options screen and click that hyperlink. Just like the estimated or extension payment, required fields are indicated by the red asterisk. In this case, we are asked to provide the letter ID and letter date from the bill we received. That can be found in the top right-hand corner of the letter, as shown on the screen. So we'll provide that information. And click Next. Based on the letter ID and letter date provided on the previous page, the bill balance is auto-populated here. Below that, we can indicate the amount that we're going to pay today and indicate which payment method we'd like to use. The two options available to us are direct debit, bank account, which looks like what we just demonstrated for the estimated and our extension payment. Credit card payments may be available as an option if the bill meets certain criteria. Maine Revenue Services cannot take credit card payments on new debt. The debt must be final, and the rights to reconsideration timeframe must have passed. For the purposes of this demonstration, the bill is final, and we are going to demonstrate a credit or debit card payment. So we've checked that box and are going to click Next to proceed. On the payment summary screen, some information is reiterated back to us based on what we've entered on previous pages. We'll confirm that looks correct, and then we'll click Pay. Before we do so, we would like to note there is language on this screen that indicates that you are going to be redirected to our payment vendor to make your credit card payment. Please be aware that Maine Revenue Services does not store any credit card information. So we'll click Pay. And we're brought to the credit card vendor's page. We'll click Verify Payment Information. On the first page we're brought to on the credit card vendor's site, the amount that we've indicated we'd like to pay is reiterated back to us. The invoice number should match the letter ID provided in the Maine Tax Portal. A quick note, while we are using test data for this payment, we are going to obscure it just for security purposes. Enter in the card number that we are using, the expiration date, and the security code. We'll enter in the billing address for that card. Our email address, and our phone number. Now that we've filled out all of our payment information and billing information, we're going to click Submit Payment. We're brought to the confirmation page where we can see our confirmation number. As always, we encourage you to make note of this information for your records. That concludes our non-logged-in payments. For the next part of this video, we're going to show you a logged-in payment. So you must have a Maine Tax Portal username and be logged in to do this. For the purpose of this demonstration, we've jumped right into the logged-in homepage. and we're going to navigate to the tax panel for the tax type for which we are making a payment. And we'll click the Make a Payment hyperlink for that tax type. On the payment screen, we're going to enter in our payment method information, including our routing number, account number, and account number again to confirm. We'll indicate whether the account is a checking or savings. And we're also asked if we'd like to save this payment channel for future use. For the purposes of today's demonstration, we're just going to leave that as no. We'll select the payment type from the dropdown. Our options for this are account payment or return payment. Since we've selected return payment, we are asked to indicate which period we are making the payment to. So we'll select that from the drop-down menu. The payment date is going to default to today, and the amount is going to default to the total amount due. You may opt to pay another amount if you so choose. Either way, you'll be asked to confirm the amount again. And we'll click Submit. We are asked to enter in our password. This does act as our signature for this activity. Once we've done so, we'll click OK. We're brought to the confirmation page where we can see our confirmation number. As always, we encourage you to make note of this information for your records. That concludes our demonstration of how to make payments on the Maine Tax Portal. Thank you all for watching.